Welcome back. We're back in the 11 News Kitchen, and we're getting ready for the big game today. A lot of people at home excited to watch it. And don't overlook the drinks when you're preparing for your Ravens party. Today, I'm here with Tim Riley from the Bagby Restaurant Group, and he's here to show you how to make some top-notch drinks to impress all your guests. So good
Absolutely,
morning.
Absolutely, Eva Marie. So we're going to do three different things today. We're going to do a beer, we're going to do a wine, and we're going to do a cocktail.
You
so three different
covered,
things.
All your
Absolutely.
Bases.
Everything, no matter what you need. And I don't know if I can match Irish Mike's shot of Irish whiskey, but we're going to try and live up to that.
We're going to
do our best. So, again, we have nothing against Natty Bo or Raven Beer, any of the traditional things, but we're going to start with something from Baltimore base, made in Baltimore and made by an artisanal producer named Brian Strumke. Brian's a local guy. He grew up here in Baltimore, and I believe he graduated from Archbishop Curley, and he started his brewery called Stillwater a couple years back, and we are going to start with his beer called Cellar Door. Mm-hmm. This is a Saison-style beer from Belgium.
Saison. I don't even know what that means.
I know. That's not too much important. It's kind of a broad style that they make during the springtime, but we're going to enjoy it right now. I think this is a great beer for the cold weather, mm-hmm. and we're going to start with this. He actually uses a little bit of white sage in mm-hmm. this beer, which is kind of interesting. Mm-hmm. There's a little bit for you.
Okay, I know it's
a little
nine
bit
in the morning.
Me.
You know, I
nine in the morning.
Try.
We got to give it a start. So right here, early in the
this
morning.
This is the kind of beer you sip.
Absolutely.
Yes.
Yeah. We put in the wine glasses. This is what Brian likes, but absolutely.
Yeah.
He makes this out in Westminster. Brian's actually all over the world. He has sent me a text mm-hmm. message. He's in Belgium right now. Mm. He makes beer all over, but
I almost hint like a fruity flavor.
Yeah,
to it.
A little bit of that too. So,
oh, good.
Beautiful.
That's actually my favorite type of
water.
Beer. Good, so you just step it up a notch, even when you're serving beer at a party.
Exactly.
Put in a wine glass.
Exactly, of course, and you're one
classy.
Step ahead.
Good, what are you going to make
next? Next thing we're going to do is a wine from Western Maryland called Black Ankle.
Mm-hmm. Keeping with the local
Absolutely,
theme.
We're going to try and stay local, and there's a lot of local wineries in Maryland right now, but we're pretty convinced that Black Ankle is the best. They grow their own grapes. It's a couple.
You're so fast at that.
Yeah.
I need to get better
This
a
is
wine.
What restaurant work does for you, Marie.
Yeah.
But
yeah.
yeah, anyway, so they drew this out in Western Maryland. This is from their own vineyard. They farm it virtually organically, which is pretty impressive.
Okay.
And this is a blend of Merlot and Cabernet. And we're going to use this. We're going to taste it together first, and then we will actually put it into a cocktail, which is pretty cool.
Well, what's great about wine, I mean, it's naturally a purple color. So
exactly. So we are already, exactly.
Okay.
We are already
a
step ahead in terms of our Ravens fanaticism here. So, again, a Merlot-based wine.
Smooth, sweet wine.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Yeah, a little bit, perhaps. And certainly, you know, really a great Maryland mm-hmm. wine. Something I think that competes, and we think competes with pretty much everything in the nation right now.
Okay, so you're going to throw this in to make a
Absolutely.
Cocktail.
What
a
we would do,
cocktail.
And we're going to kind of cheat here, but what we would normally do is we would put this into a pan. We would reduce mm-hmm. it down a little bit. We'd
Cooking
add
down some of the alcohol.
Exactly. We'd cook off a little bit and add a little bit of sugar, and we would turn that into a syrup.
And that's raw sugar.
Exactly.
Okay.
That's turbinado kind of thing you might have seen as sugar in the raw.
Okay.
But I'm actually going to do that. We're going to kind of cheat here and, again, do it a step ahead here. So we have a little bit that's already made, and so we're going to mix up one for you and one for me.
And now definitely the beer and the wine are going to be served at 1010 Restaurant.
Exactly.
Your
this cocktail is something
up.
That we
Maybe if
are
you
making.
Ask for it,
exactly.
They'll make it for,
you, Eva Marie, we would definitely make
it's
this cocktail.
It's not on the list yet, but
exactly.
this cocktail you can get it. It's a good idea to make for your party today. So we're
Beautiful.
Putting in the wine.
Exactly.
What was this here?
This
that you
is
added?
A little bit of rye whiskey, from Virginia.
Okay.
There's no rye whiskey made in Maryland right now. I'm a little bit worried these guys could be Redskins fans, but we're going to do our best
we'll
either
hide it
way.
With the purple.
Exactly. We're going to take the syrup that we made from the red wine and the raw sugar. Exactly. We're going to do about an ounce of that syrup. And we will add that to both of our drinks here.
Mm.
Exactly. Get a nice purple color there.
Okay.
We're going to use a little bit of a liqueur from Trinidad called Allspice Dram. It's really spicy if you want to smell it, made
Ooh,
from allspice
it does
berries.
Have a kick to it.
We'll just do a little splash of that.
Okay.
Exactly.
And then how do you serve this? With ice?
We would not serve it with ice. We're actually going to add a dash of bitters. We're going to add some hot water. So, again, like I said, it's going to be tough
oh,
for me
so
to
warm.
Compete with Irish Mike there and his mm-hmm. warming Irish whiskey. It is going to come up warm for us.
So you've got the temperature warming, and then you've got the
exactly.
kick from the alcohol as well.
Exactly. And a little bit of citrus
help.
That I'm adding right here, too. And we have our drink. Let me just stir it up for us here.
Got to get the warm
exactly.
water
we want to get it nice and warm and get our nice purple color there. Beautiful.
Mm.
We can kind of stir it up, and we should
oh my
be
gosh.
Ready
well, good.
To
well, we're
going to
take a sip of this real quick. We're running out of time.
Oh,
and
apologize.
It's 9:32 and 26 degrees on TV Hill. You're going to need something warm to keep you warm today as we cheer on the
Absolutely.
Ravens.
Absolutely. Cheers, Avery Marie.